So what is going on, everyone? Fernando Silva here with another video, and today we got a little bit of a different one. So with the new year starting and finances kind of being on the forefront of everybody's mind, I wanted to kind of show off the bank that I've been using over the last 4 years that's been absolutely amazing, and I just highly recommend it to you guys. And that bank is called Chime Bank, and I'm going to show you guys exactly why I absolutely love it. Let's get right into it. So firstly, if you guys actually just want to skip this video, check it out and find out for yourselves, it'll be the first link in the description. And I do believe they're running a promotion through the end of this month, whereas if you sign up and then sign up for their direct deposit, once you get that first direct deposit, then you get an extra $75 just on them for joining their platform, joining their program. And when I joined, they were only doing $50. So $75 isn't a bad deal. It's basically free money as long as you can put your direct deposit information into that bank account. But without further ado, let's get right into it and talk about Chime Bank and why I think it's the best mobile banking platform so far on the market. So to break this video down and make it as easy as possible to digest, we're gonna break it down into four different categories here. And those categories are the mobile first UI interface, all the awesome banking features that it has, their credit building feature, and all the security initiatives that they've gone through to make sure that everybody feels as safe as possible with their hard-earned money in their banking platform. So let's start with the first category, which I said is that mobile-first UI interface. So the reason Chime Bank came around, they were built as a mobile-first platform. They wanted to build a bank that was solely focused on the user interface from a tech perspective, right? Their slogan is, finally a bank built by a tech company, which is ideally what they are, right? They built the entire front end of this application and it looks gorgeous. I love it. It's very, very simple, very easy to read, very easy to use, and everything is kind of just in your face, so you don't really need to go through different menus and options to find out everything that you need to find. And the reason it's kind of gotten so good from a UI perspective is because they're able to invest money that they're not spending on brick and mortar shops like a classic, you know, Wells Fargo or Bank of America or Capital One. They don't have brick and mortar shops. So what they do is they reinvest that money into developing their app and making it the best that it could possibly be. So overall, the UI is amazing. I love it on both the iPad and the iPhone. They have a dedicated iPhone application and you can use it on the iPad, but I use the web version of Chime on the iPad itself. And then I just created a little bookmark on my home screen so I can just quickly log into it. And I like it that way instead of having that 2X version of an iPhone app. But it was definitely built for the iPhone first. So if you have an iPhone, definitely check it out. And obviously if you're an Android user, they also have an Android app, but we're strictly Apple over here on this channel for the most part. So now let's talk about the actual banking features, category number two. So from a banking feature perspective, they're loaded. They have a bunch of different things to offer you to incentivize you to actually join their platform. So the biggest one that I use, and I've never turned this feature off, is that 10% auto saving feature. So basically if you do have your direct deposit enabled, then 10% of your entire direct deposit, instead of going into your checking account, goes directly into your savings account. So if you're somebody like me who never even looks at their savings account, it's kind of nice to eventually go back and see that you've been putting 10% of basically all of your income for it, however long you've had that feature turned on. So it's a nice little surprise at the end of it. So the way I look at it is that my entire income is actually just 90% and that other 10% just gets automatically auto-saved into my savings account, which is a beautiful thing to see. Another awesome feature is that 2 days early payday, right? So let's say if you get paid on the 15th and the 30th of the month, you would essentially get them on the 13th and the 29th or the 28th, depending on how long the month is. And then sometimes if something falls on a weekend kind of weirdly and they process payroll at a certain point, there's some days where I've gotten my payroll up to 5 days early because of like a weekend schedule and having to process early. Because once everything is processed from your employer side, then Chime Bank immediately sees that no matter what time of day it is and they send it right to you. There's no normal 2 day grace period to wait around. So I don't know how they did that, but I love that feature. And you know, my money comes in a little bit earlier than usual, which is awesome to see. Another nice savings feature is the roundup feature. Now I've seen this in other applications and other ways to actually implement this feature, but for Chime Bank, you know, they run off of a debit card. And with that debit card, if you use that debit card, which for the most part, I don't really recommend using because there's so many ways to, you know, gather points in other areas with credit cards and things like that. But if you use your debit card as your sole way of payment, then there's a roundup feature. So basically it rounds up to the nearest dollar and that extra change goes into your savings account automatically again. So if you spend $3.50 on a cup of coffee at Dunkin' Donuts and you use your debit card, then 50 cents will go from your checking into your savings account and it's just there. So it's another way to kind of accumulate some savings if you are using your debit card as your form of payment. And then the last thing with the features that's obviously one of the biggest selling points is no fees. And this kind of goes back to the first category because, again, they don't have the high expense and overhead of a ton of employees, of rent, of maintenance, of having, again, that brick and mortar expense and overhead to have. So again, what they do is they then turn that around and bring it back to us, which means zero fees. So no overdraft fees, no late fees. You don't have to have any minimums in either of your savings or checking account. There's nothing that they charge you. I've never been charged at all. And on top of that, if you go to an ATM that does charge you, they'll reimburse you that ATM charge, which is amazing, amazing to see. So category number three has to do with this new credit builder feature, which released fairly recently for Chime. So a lot of people, the reason they go with the bigger banks is because yes, you have your checking and savings account, but then you can tie that into a credit card, build your credit and kind of work that way. So Chime saw this as an opportunity to create their own version of that. And what they did is basically they added another account within your bank account called the credit builder account. And what you do is you move actual money from either your savings or your checking into that account. And then that is used as a credit builder bank account. So basically whenever you swipe that credit builder card, which is a different card from the debit card, I'll show you guys in a second, and then pulls money from that credit builder account and then reports that to the credit bureaus. And it's as if you're making payments immediately after you make a purchase. So you're making your credit card payments on time. And again, that gets reported and it helps build your credit. So it's a way, it's almost like a prepaid credit card that goes towards building your credit. That's the best way I can describe it. And I think it's a great feature, especially if you're somebody who is looking to build their credit. You know, you're starting off with your first credit card, you're starting off with your first bank account. It's a great, great way to start building simple credit and without having to worry about it either, without having to worry about minimum fees or having to pay at the end of the month, because automatically that money's already in there. And if that money isn't in that credit builder account, then the credit card will be declined whenever you swipe. So it's essentially a glorified debit card that allows you to build your credit. And then lastly, we have to talk about security. Security for bank is probably the end all be all, because it is your hard earned money that you're depositing it into a different company's, you know, platform or bank or whatever the case may be. And you ideally have to trust them, right? And a lot of people kind of take that for granted. It's crazy how we just hand all this money, all the money that we earn, that we make for all the hours that we put in, it goes into the bank. And again, like I said, people take that for granted, but with Chime, you know, they follow all the standard guidelines for any normal bank, like Bank of America, or Wells Fargo, or Capital One. And again, they're FDIC insured up to $250,000. They have their Face ID and Touch ID security interface. They use their 128-bit AES encryption, which is standard across that entire industry. And then they also have features like Instant Block Card if you lose your card automatically, and then they'll send you one instantly, which is really nice to see. So there's all those nice little features that gives you peace of mind when actually using Chime Bank. And that's what I've really liked about it. And it's worked great. I've never had any security issue with my bank account. Again, I was a very early adopter. I want to say 2017 is when I actually signed up with the bank, and I've been with them ever since. They are my main bank of choice, and I have all my checking and savings account in there. And then again, a little bit of credit builder. I use it on occasion because I have other credit cards, but the credit builder is there to again help especially younger people build their credit as they're starting to get into the world of working, guys. But that's pretty much gonna do with this video. Like I said, it's gonna be linked below. If you guys wanna take advantage of that feature, getting a free $75 influx of cash into your bank account, by all means, give it a shot. Like I said, link is in the description, first one below. And don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and let me know if you guys enjoyed videos like this. And if you guys want me to maybe touch on a little bit more about how I handle finances, maybe even talk about the YouTube finances and how I kind of structure that. But let me know what you guys think. Until next time, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe.